What's up, everyone? Thanks for joining me on Reconciled Reality TV. Today we're going to discuss the word condemnation. You know, how the believer is no longer under condemnation thanks to Jesus' blood, his sacrifice on the cross. It brought us out of condemnation. It brought us out of guilt. And just that root word condemnation. We've got a couple of scriptures today that I just want to kind of go over. First one is in Romans chapter 8, verse 1. It says, "There is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus. Do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit." That means that when we are born again, when a believer comes to Jesus and Jesus pulls them out of that old sinful nature, and you are eradicated from that sinful past, you know, you are brought new, you're made new. The Bible says you are a new creation. We're going to look at that scripture in a second. But in Romans 8, it says that you are dead to sin and you're alive in Christ. It means that whenever Jesus lives inside of you, you are no longer under that condemnation, that guilt of sin. You know, if we slip up, you know, and the devil tries to come in and, like, you know, say, "Oh, you know, you're supposed to be this good Christian. You know, how can you be doing this?" No longer are you under condemnation. You don't have to feel that guilt and weight and burden of condemnation. Actually, condemnation is a root that lifts off all this guilt, you know, this heaviness. You know, whenever we live under condemnation, you know, sickness can come in, you know, because you're like, oh, you know, you're stressing, you know, you're depressed, you know, you feel guilty, you have that condemnation, that weight is such a heavy load, you know, and the Bible says we're no longer under that. The devil might try to come trip us up and condemn us, you know, here and there, you know, but we're no longer under that. Just tell the devil to shut up and go about your business, you know, live that guilt-free, that condemnation-free life. Hallelujah. And another couple of scriptures I want to look at are actually both in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17 and verse 19. It says, verse 17 says, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new." Beloved, whenever you come to Jesus, you are that old sinful past is cut away with. You are actually grafted into a new existence. You are a new creature thanks to Jesus. You are no longer seen as that dirty, rotten sinner. You know, you are seen beautiful and holy and perfect in the eyes of the Father. Actually, I just want to keep on reading from verse 17 through 18, 19. I'm just going to keep reading. It says, verse 18, "Now all things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself through Jesus Christ and has given us the ministry of reconciliation." Jesus reconciled us back to our Father, back to our Papa, back to our Daddy God. It's in verse 19, it says, "That is, that God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself, not imputing their trespasses," their sin, "to them, and has committed to us word of reconciliation." We have been reconciled back to God. You are holy, perfect. When God looks at you, he sees Jesus. Verse 20, it says, "Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God were pleading through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf to be reconciled to God. For he made him who knew no sin," he made Jesus who knew no sin, "to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God." Holy, holy, holy Jesus. He came. He died in your place. He took that punishment. You know, he sacrificed his life for you. He took away that old simple nature, dying for your sins, dying, you know, for your guilt, dying for your condemnation. He was condemned so you wouldn't be condemned. You are holy and perfect because Jesus Christ died in your place. He took that sin, you know, that weight of sin, you know, that we once loved to do, but now once we hate it now, you know, we are a new creation. Now, don't live under that condemnation, you know. You know, we need to renew our minds daily to the fact that we are no longer sinners, but we are saints, you know, we have been reconciled back to our Papa God. Hallelujah. We are living in a family. You know, we are one with Jesus. He lives inside of us. That Holy Spirit, that Holy Ghost is just there to teach us, renew our minds of what we have in Christ, you know, that we can call out Abba Father, you know, we can come to our daddy and just like, just lay him love on us, you know, that we don't have to feel condemned, you know, we don't have to beat ourselves up, you know, day in and day out, like, oh, I did this, you know, the word repentance actually, it means just turning back to the high point, you know. It's like when we take our focus, you know, off the cross, you know, we maybe slip up, we maybe sin, you know, might look at pornography, you know, on the internet, you know, we might cuss out somebody, you know, we might, you know, in our minds, we might hate someone, you know, we wish death upon them, you know, we might slip up, you know, maybe steal something, just do something stupid, you know, not even any of those, you know, maybe you're struggling with something else, you know, just like we can come back to our Papa God because Jesus died, you know, reconciling us back to our Father, you know, and that word condemnation, you know, it's such a heavy word, you know, it has so many, like, things that cause us, you know, that when we're, like I said, when we're condemned, you know, we're like beating ourselves up, you know, we can, that guilt will like weigh us down, you know, we can become sick, you know, just depressed, that and it starts, you know, we'll take our eyes back off Jesus, you know, and put it on like sinfulness, you know, when we're no longer even sinners, we're saints, you know, when you slip up, just take this, turn back to the Father, you know, okay, you messed up, you know, cool, you know, everyone's gonna mess up, you know, but thing is that Jesus died for us, you know, that we have that perfection of Jesus, that righteousness of Jesus, not to say that we're perfect, but we are perfect, you know, in God's eyes, we are now perfect. People want to say, oh, you know, no one's perfect. Well, actually, no, the Bible says you are perfect because Jesus died for you. You are one with Jesus. You've been engrafted into that holy lifestyle. You are a new creation. You are holy. You are perfect. You are loved by Papa, and Jesus and died for you. You know, you are dead to sin and alive in Christ, you know, Romans 6 says, you know, and it says that actually whenever he died, you actually died with him, you know, that was also, you know, in a spiritual realm, you died with him, you were nailed to the cross, you were buried with him, and you rose up with newness. Jesus lives inside of you. God doesn't see you as a dirty, rotten sinner. He doesn't see you as a blasphemer. He doesn't see you as a homosexual. He sees you as his son, a loving son. Daughter, you know, Jesus, oh my goodness, it's such good news that is the gospel, you know, and what makes it so good news, if it was so hard, you know, to believe, you know, it's so hard to like, oh man, to wrap our minds around what Jesus did for us, you know, that he died in our place, that he died a death that we couldn't die, that so we would no longer have to be condemned, you know, that we would no longer have to beat ourselves up, you know, that we can be righteousness focused instead of sin focused. It's basically kind of one of the same. Whenever you're sin focused, you're going to be condemned, you know, because you're going to be like, oh, I messed up, you know, you're just going to dwell on that. You're like, oh man, you know, it's good to be like apologetic, you know, and kind of feel bad, you know, it's just nature, you know, oh man, you know, because if you didn't, you'd be like, oh, okay, well, that's weird, you know, but the thing is, don't let it just weigh you down, you know, okay, you feel bad, you know, I think the word, you know, also in repentance, you know, when we come and say, oh, I'm sorry, God, that's just to humble us, like I said on a couple videos back, you know, that's to keep us humble. Now, there's no need for that, you know, we don't need to say sorry to get forgiveness, you know what I mean, like, because we are already forgiven by Jesus. It says, Jesus said that it's finished, you know, it's done. You are fully forgiven, 1,000 times, 1,000% forgiven. You are holy and perfect. Now, just renew your mind to the fact that, like I said in Romans 8:1, that you are no longer under condemnation, that those who are in Christ, if you are in Christ, you're born again, you know, you, Jesus came to you, he plucked you out, it's nothing that you did, but he plucked you out of that, you know, you accepted his sacrifice, you are no longer condemned. Tell the devil to shut up and just live in victory, live like a son and daughter, holy and perfect, like God created us to be in the first place before Adam messed it up, you know, he created us to be that way, you know, and Adam messed it up, you know, but Jesus was the last Adam, so he straightened it all out. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for watching. Man, thank you, Jesus, that you are a finisher. You are a holy and holy perfect Savior. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Be blessed. Have a great week, guys.